Baseline. generation that shall be born.
Yeah. was with Peter Todd Bray?
He was very brave. Are you going to be?
I'll try.
I know you will. And I'm sure that your Peter's son would want you to have that.
What will happen to me now?
You let me worry about that, Green Beret. You're what this is all about.
Back at home, a young white queen.
Ha 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 ha! Well, the family gets up in the morning and they look around and where's Minnehaha, you know, with the father, and you know how Indians are, he looked around, he said, she's run off with a buffalo. He could see by the footsteps. So he says, I'm going to get her back. So puts on his walking moccasins, bow and arrow and so forth, and goes out over the plains. He's gone quite a distance when he feels he better sit down and rest. And he comes to a place that's called a buffalo wallow, where the buffalo like to come and roll around and get the lice off and roll around in the mud. So he sits down there and is thinking what he should do now, when along comes a magpie, not a beautiful flashing bird. And it's one of those clever birds that has shamanic qualities.
Magical qualities.
Magical. And the man says to him, oh, beautiful bird, he said, my daughter ran away with a buffalo. Have you seen, will you hunt around and see if you can find her out on the plain somewhere? And the magpie says, well, there's a lovely girl with the buffaloes right now over there, just a bit away. Well, they said, the man, will you go tell her that her daddy's here, her father's here at the buffalo wallow? Magpie flies over, and the girl is there among the buffalo. They're all asleep. I don't know what she's doing, knitting or something of the kind. And the magpie comes over close to her and says, your father's over at the wallow waiting for you. Oh, she says, this is terrible. This is dangerous. I mean, these buffalo, they'll kill us. You tell him to wait. I'll be over. I'll try to work this out. So her buffalo husband's behind her, and he wakes up and takes off a horn. He says, go to the wallow and get me a drink. So she takes the horn and goes over, and there's her father. He grabs it by the arm. He says, come. She says, no, this is real danger. The whole herd, they'll be right after us. I have to work this thing out. Now, let me just go back. So she gets the water and goes back, and he, fee-fi-fo-fum, I smell the blood of an Indian, you know, that sort of thing. And she says, no, nothing of the kind. He says, yes, indeed. So he gives a buffalo bellow, and they all get up. They all do a slow buffalo dance with their tails raised, and they go over and they trample that poor man to death so that he disappears entirely. He's just all broken up to pieces and all gone. The girl's crying, and her buffalo husband says, so you're crying? This is my daddy. He said, yeah, but what about us? There are our children, our wives, our parents, and you crying about your daddy. Well, apparently he was a kind of sympathetic, compassionate buffalo. And he said, well, I'll tell you, if you can bring your daddy back to life again, I'll let you go. So she turns to the magpie and says, see, peck around a little bit and see if you can find a bit of daddy. And the magpie does so, and he comes up finally with a vertebra, just one little bone. And the little girl says, that's plenty. Now, we put this down on the ground, and she puts her blanket over it, and she sings a revivifying song, a magical song with great power. And presently, yes, there's a man under the blanket. She looks, daddy all right, but he's not breathing yet. A few more stanzas of whatever the song was, and he stands up, and the buffalo are amazed. And they say, well, why don't you do this for us? We'll teach you now our buffalo dance, and when you will have killed our families, you do this dance and sing this song, and we'll all be back alive again. That's the basic idea, that through the ritual, that dimension is struck which transcends temporality, and out of which life comes and back into which it goes.
And it goes back to this whole idea of death, burial, and resurrection, not only for human beings,
but for the animals too.
So the story of the buffalo's wife was told to confess.